Dez, King of the Pit TV signing in. This one's entitled First Date. This is track 3 of 16. And without further ado, shout out to David Rolfe's Rock and Metal channel. I'm going to be listening to a few playlists off of this one. He's lined up quite a few good bits of material for me. I've got The Darkness lined up and Audio Slave. I've never listened to Audio Slave before. Let's go. I've heard this one before. Forever. Let's make this last forever. Is that the tune? I think I've heard this one. Where have I heard this? That crack. Does somebody want to tell me where I've heard this tune before? I've not optionally listened to this before, so tell me where I've heard this. Great tune, isn't it? It's a great chorus, definitely. Yeah, where have I heard that song before? That's a good tune. You know what I was saying on the last track, I need something good to come up to really you know, influence me that this record's going to be pretty good, and that's a great song, isn't it? You know what, we'll give you a double whammy. Let's listen to the next track because it's only 45 seconds long. Happy Holidays. Yeah, let's go. Don't know what to expect. Is it gonna be a sample? Is it gonna be a fast tune? It's only one way to find out in the people. It's Christmas Eve and I've only wrapped two fucking presents. Christmas Eve and I've only wrapped two fucking presents. And I hate your guts. I hate your guts. And I'll never talk to you again. Unless your dad will suck me off. I'll never talk to you again. Unless your mom will touch my car. I'll never talk to you again. If I get laid into a song, I'll never talk to you again. I'll never talk to you again. It's Labor Day and my grandpa just ate seven fucking hot dogs. Labor Day and my grandpa just ate seven fucking hot dogs. And he shit his pants. He's always fucking shit his pants. And I'll never talk to you again. Yo, I've got one thought on that, right? They've made a ridiculous, like, novelty song, but they crammed it into 45 seconds long. You see that they haven't taken the time to orchestrate a full well-ground song around like that concept and that lyrical content, which I think may be an indirect showcase of how seriously they took things. Don't get me wrong, like soundscape-wise, it sounds pretty good, but you are paying, you know, a producer money, or at least Blink-182's label is fronting them a heavy loan off of recording a good record. And I think a little bit of quirk does the trick, but yeah, they didn't orchestrate a full 3 minute tune about that, did they? Which I think might have been the smart thing to do, because we want to hear the more well, I don't know, I want to hear the grown up stuff, but I wasn't listening to Blink when I was a teenager, so you know what I mean, probably different for other people anyway.